12. All those things, for matter of experience, are usual and ordinary. For their continuance, but for a day, and for that matter, most base and filthy. As they were in the days of those whom we have buried, so are they now also, and no otherwise. 13. The things themselves that affect us, they stand without doors, neither knowing anything themselves, nor able to utter anything unto others concerning themselves. What then is it that passeth verdict on them? The understanding. 14. As virtue and wickedness consist not in passion, but in action, so neither do the true good or evil of a reasonable charitable man consist in passion, but in operation and action. 15. To the stone that is cast up, when it comes down, it is no hurt unto it, as neither benefit when it doth ascend. 16. Sift their minds and understandings, and behold what men they be, whom thou dost stand in fear of, what they shall judge of thee, what they themselves judge of themselves. 17. All things that are in this world are always in the estate of alteration. Thou also art in a perpetual change, yea, and under corruption too, in some part, and so is the whole world. 18. It is not thine, but another man's sin. Why should it trouble thee? Let him look to it whose sin it is. 19. If an operation and of a purpose there is an ending, or of an action and a purpose, we say commonly, that it is at an end. From opinion also there is an absolute cessation, which is, as it were, the death of it. In all this there is no hurt. Apply this now to a man's age, as first a child, then a youth, then a young man, then an old man. Every change from one age to another is a kind of death. And all this while here, no matter of grief yet. Pass now unto that life first, that which thou livest under thy grandfather, then under thy mother, then under thy father. And thus, when through the whole course of thy life hitherto thou hast found and observed many alterations, many changes, many kinds of endings and cessations, put this question to thyself. What matter of grief or sorrow dost thou find in any of these? Or what dost thou suffer through any of these? If in none of these, then neither in the ending and consummation of thy whole life, which is also but a cessation and change. 20. As occasion shall require, either to thine own understanding, or to that of the universe, or to his whom thou hast now to do with, let thy refuge be with all speed, to thine own that it resolve upon nothing against justice, to that of the universe that thou mayest remember part of whom thou art, of his that thou mayest consider whether in the estate of ignorance or of knowledge, and then also must thou call to mind that he is thy kinsman. 21. As thou thyself, whoever thou art, were made for the perfection and consummation, being a member of it, of a common society, so must every action of thine tend to the perfection and consummation of a life that is truly sociable. What action soever of thine, therefore, that either immediately or afar off, hath no reference to the common good, that is an exorbitant and disorderly action, yea, it is sedentious, as one among the people who, from such and such a consent and unity, should factiously divide and separate himself. 22. Children's anger, mere babbles, wretched souls bearing up dead bodies, that they may not have their fall so soon, even as it is in that common dirge song. 23. Go to the quality of the cause from which the effect doth proceed. Behold it by itself bare and naked, separated from all that is material. Then consider the utmost bounds of time, that that cause, thus and thus qualified, can subsist and abide. 24. Infinite are the troubles and miseries that thou hast already been put to, by reason of this only, because that for all happiness it did not suffice thee, or that thou didst not account it sufficient happiness, that thy understanding did operate according to its natural constitution. 25. When any shall either impeach thee with false accusations, or hatefully approach thee, or shall use any such carriage towards thee. Get thee presently to their minds and understandings, and look in them, and behold what manner of men they be. Thou shalt see that there is no such occasion why it should trouble thee, what such as they are think of thee. Yet must thou love them still, for by nature they are thy friends. And the gods themselves, in those things that they seek from them as matters of great moment, are well content. All manner of ways, as by dreams and oracles, to help them as well as others. 26. Up and down from one age to another go the ordinary things of the world, being still the same. And either of everything in particular before it come to pass, the mind of the universe doth consider with itself and deliberate.